Alyssa. Godfather, Reverend Anthony Stafford, bless his heart, forth in Washington.
Come on, baby. Come on.
Yeah, that's a good card. Go. Lord, we thank you for Felicia and Andrew. We ask your continued blessings upon them, that you would strengthen them. And we ask for strength for all of those who will witness this ceremony, and that their marriage would be an example as you are an example for us. And so we ask your blessings even now as we get started. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. At this time, we're going to have the Old Testament reading by the Father, Mr. Michael Overmiller, followed by the New Testament reading by Brother Tim Overmiller. They will come.
God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones, the flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of me. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother, join to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." The Apostle Paul, wrote in 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 to 8, that love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, and always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Let me just add that this kind of love enriches each part of life, and marriage enriches love. Two lives shared with this kind of love can hold more fulfillment and happiness than either life alone.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this covenant to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union betwixt Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adored and beautified with his presence and first miracle that he wrought in Cana of Galilee. It is commendable of St. Paul to be honorable above all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently. soberly and in the fear of God into this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak or hereafter hold his peace. There being none. Andrew, would you step a little bit closer? Andrew Overmiller, will thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Amen. Felicia Cooper, will thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love him, comfort him, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Gives this woman to be married to this man. About to receive his. And if you would note, the ring is circled. Yes. Holy Spirit. Amen. Salute.